Hello friends, my name is Nitin Goyal. I am Associate Professor, Curin Department, Chitkara University. Friends, today the topic is Underwater Wireless Sensor Network. I am here to make you familiar with this topic, that what is it? So all of us knows that Earth is 70% covered with water. So actually we can say that 70% of part of Earth is water, which is largely unexplored. It is not yet explored. We need to explore it. We need to explore it for getting the valuable resources. We need to discover all these valuable resources. These resources we need to explore for the reason, if we will explore these resources, then we will be getting some kind of oil mines. These are natural resources, oil mines. For example, these can be evaluated using this. So these are the sort of chemical leakages. You can say this leads to the oil wastage. By using UWSN, by having this sensor network, we can evaluate this oil wastage. Timely reporting of these disasters. Disasters may happen, we cannot stop this, but if we came to know about this timely, then it can be the fact that the disaster can be reduced up to the extent the most deadly tsunami in human history was Indian earthquake named as Sumatra on 26/12/2004, which leads to disasters. If we came to know about this little earlier, then the lives can be harmed less in this. Third is for defense. It is helpful for defense if we'll explore the underwater areas. In defense, we can see that we see that submarines are there, so these submarines can detect the enemy submarine if we will deploy this sensor network. This is one example. Manual monitoring can be reduced by using this. Previously we need to go to this way the manual deployment, but now what we can do, the sensors can be deployed. These sensors will send the reading and manual monitoring will become very much less. Gaseous level of water. Due to the gaseous level, the harm to animals, the underwater animals, the fishes is there much more. But if you will be able to detect these faults, where it is, what is the source, what is the area, then we can easily eliminate this or reduce this. So that's why we need to explore the underwater areas, which is covering 70% of Earth. So now it came towards UWSN, which is actually the sensor network. It consists of a number of sensor nodes and vehicles deployed under the water that is used to monitor underwater conditions. These underwater conditions can be temperature, pressure, like so. We can also call this as underwater acoustic network or underwater communication network, UAN, UWCN. There are numerous applications of this. Some of the important applications are like oceanographic data collection. In the picture, as we can see, these are AUVs, autonomous underwater vehicles. They collect the data from seabed, transmit it to another AUV, and through a gateway, it gets transmitted to the onshore base station. Disaster prevention can be the application of this. We know that the tectonic plate movements under the water creates the problems like tsunami. If we cannot stop it, but if we will be able to detect their movement, then we can reduce the disasters that may handle, that may carried due to this. So this is also the application, assisted navigation. You can see in the picture the ships, if will get navigation timely, then the disasters like this as shown in Alaska on 5th of August 1910 can be reduced. Pollution and environment monitoring. We know that a lot of pollution is going on these days under the water, especially in seas. This can be reduced or this can be monitored if you deploy underwater sensor network. For scientific exploration, we also need underwater sensor network, that what is there below the water, a AUV or an underwater vehicle can be deployed to check all over these as shown in the figure. Now how it works? It works in a way that nodes are deployed. These nodes as shown in white dotted, known as underwater sensor nodes. These nodes send their data to another sensor node, which is can be said as data aggregator of, or if it is a cluster, then cluster head. It ultimately goes to the base station, that is on the water base station, or you can say offshore base station. And this offshore base station, if it is far away, then through the help of satellite, it can send data to the onshore base station. This is the main working of underwater sensor network, by which the sensors collect the data from under the water and send it to the offshore and onshore base stations. Why it is said to be the challenging area? UWSN nowadays is very challenging, and it is the most emerging area in case of sensor network, because we have deployed a sensor network. Now we have to take these its challenges as well into account. What are those challenges and how it is different? First is communication method. The communication method is acoustic signals, or you can say non-electromagnetic signals. As in case of wireless sensor network, we use the electromagnetic signals, or you can say radio waves. But in case of underwater, these radio waves do not work, as because of dense water medium. Second challenge is the battery power, that is very limited in case of UWSN, as because in wireless sensor network the battery can be recharged. It can be recharged via solar cells, it can be recharged through the sunlight, it can be recharged through wired connection. But in case of underwater, it is very tough, or you can say it is nearly impossible, because the batteries deployed below the water cannot be recharged and the sunlight doesn't work over there. Third challenge is limited bandwidth. Bandwidth is very limited in case of UWSN, as because of dense medium again. It gets degraded very soon as it travels below the water. Fourth challenge or difference is communication equipment cost. Whatever the equipments we are using in case of UWSN is very costly, and in case of UWSN we cannot deploy those all those sensors which are used in WSN. They needs to be captured in a glass vessel so that they can not get corrosion and fouling so easily, and they are used in a way that they can send their readings correctly, so they are having high cost. Fifth challenge is requirement of dense deployment. As we know, water is itself having the speed of 3 meter per second, and it is to be said as 3 meter per second drift. Due to this drift, the sensor gets displaced from one position to another position. That's why we need to deploy densely these sensors, so that if at a place the sensors are not there due to water drift, any other sensor can take the place of this sensor. And sixth challenge is, it is more prone to failure and propagation delay. Because of water medium, the delay is much more. That is the possibility in case of UWSN only. We are motivated to work in UWSN as because there are so many challenges, as Earth on Earth, ocean and river always remain the least explored area. Natural disasters like tsunami and earthquake always attracts to work towards working towards UWSN. Gaseous level of water also attracts to work in UWSN. Chemical leakages in UWSN is much more, and very much unexplored Bermuda Triangle problem is also there. Now, to solve these problems, to do effective communication is much more necessary, as because if there will be effective communication, then data can be transferred from one area to another area so fastly and timely that it can be captured in a way that we can little bit overcome these problems as we discussed above. So for effective communication, one can do data aggregation and data fusion and data dissemination, data forwarding, data integrity. These all are much important in this aspect. These all are required for the effective communication of data in case of UWSN. In case of UWSN, if we are going to explore this as the layered approach, then there are many layers that is possible: physical layer, MAC layer, network layer, transport layer, and application layer. Out of these, network layer and transport layer are much more important, needs to be worked more and more. There are many challenges on these layers: physical layer, jamming and tampering, MAC layer, collision, exhaustion and unfairness, network layer, misdirection, black hole and wormhole, transport layer, flooding and desynchronization. Now there comes some of the simulation tools. These tools are much more necessary for the simulation purpose, like NS2, OMNET++ and QuailNet. These three tools can be used. These are used for both wired and wireless connection. They use C++ and C for this purpose. NS2 is most widely used tool for underwater sensor network. These tools are easy for or helpful for the implementation purposes. There are some of the references that is used over here. So thank you very much, guys. If you need any kind of related help, you can mail me at nitin.goyal@chitkara.edu.in. Thanks for watching. Thanks a lot.